Now I'd like to show you how the pushdown automaton that we constructed in the last video processes words. For example, I take the word A triple D, and well, this will be for the automaton to show you how it works. But I don't want to write the word twice, so I write it down here. And the definition says the automaton creates a leftmost derivation, so I will write to you a leftmost derivation where I derive this word. And I will write it beside the table. So I have to start with a start symbol. I have only one rule to take, so S expands to ABC, so I will replace S by ABC. Now, leftmost derivation means that we process the non-terminal next, which is the leftmost in the string. So in this case, it's B. And I write into this line the next derivation step. I will replace B by CD. And C just stays there. Then I process the next C. And the next one I have to write into Z line. I replace the last C by those D. I could have taken the other rule as well, but then the word would be longer than what I need here. So, here I get A triple D. And now, well, it looks maybe a little bit stupid with all those blanks inside that, but let's see how the automaton processes the word. At the beginning, we have the bottom symbol, which is Z0. And we start in the initial state, which is Q0. Now we have to take this transition where we read nothing from the input symbol, so I just write those repeat signs here. I pop Z0 from the stack and I push S Z0 onto the stack, and the S will be on top, so well, exactly, I would push the Z0 first and then the S, but well, if I read it from left to right, then I push S Z0. So, and I went to Q1. In the next step, well, let's see what transitions I can take. I have the S on top of the stack, so I can just take this transition, where I read nothing from the input symbol. I pop the S from the stack and I replace it by the string that former was my right hand side of the rule. So I just keep the Z0. I pop the S and I push down ABC. And the state is again Q1, and we will stay in it for a while. So I will just write down those points, dots. Sorry. Next, we have terminal A on top of the stack. So I have to take that transition where I read an A from the word, and I pop an A from the stack. So the first A is consumed and we are left with 3 D's. And from the stack also the A is popped and what's left is B, C, Z0. Now we have the B on top of the stack, so I can only take this transition where I read nothing from the input string. I pop B and I push CD. So I push CD, which was former my B. The C is just left there, and that zero is left there. Next we have the C on top of the stack. I have two transitions that I can take, but well, it just makes sense for me to take this one now. So we are just left with the 3D. I pop the C and replace it by a D. And the rest just stays there. Now I have to take again this transition. I read a D from the input string and I push, I pop a D from the stack. So this one is consumed and one of the D's is consumed. Now we have another D on top of the stack, so I can just do the same again. And we are left with a C on top of the stack, so I take again this transition and replace a C by a D. And I take again that transition where I consume the last D and I'm left with an empty string. And here I am left with a bottom symbol. And now I can take the last transition from Q1 to QF, so F is my final state, where I pop the Z0 from the stack and where I push nothing back. And before I was in Q1 and now I'm in QF. Now the automaton accepted the word because the input string is empty and the stack is also empty. And if you now compare the leftmost derivation with the stack, then you see that, well, anytime you replace a non-terminal in the string by the right-hand side of the rule, the automaton does nearly the same. So, well, let me make this clear. Here I replace S by ABC. And here I have an S on top of the stack and I'm also replacing it by ABC. So here you can see that the automaton really does the same as the leftmost derivation.